The best NOFAP strategy. Hello guys, welcome back to Alpha Show, a channel that will completely change your life from negative to positive and make you the person you always wanted to be. After this video, you will have learned the best NOFAP strategy to finally quit the habit that constantly makes you hate yourself and feel powerless. Masturbation can be depressive, especially when someone really desires to stop it. They feel they have no self-control and their life is spiraling out of reach while they just watch it swing away on masturbation session after another. No one deserves to feel the hell that comes with the frustrating overindulgence in masturbation. This is about a problem that is not so easy to quit. Even married men battle with masturbation, but hey, I come bearing great news. This video is about proven and practical steps on how to be totally free from the devastating grip of masturbation. Let me start with a substantial question. If masturbation is really healthy, according to doctors and other health practitioners, why do thousands of people keep sharing harrowing experiences and their desires to quit porn and masturbation for good? Maybe these things aren't so healthy after all. So, scientists are wrong on this one. Science cannot prove any negative effect of porn and masturbation on our health. In fact, it advocates for more consumption of these things, especially masturbation, citing various healthy benefits. But a stinging effect these habits all have on us is far more psychological than physical, and that is why addiction is so crushing and overpowering. Check out my What Porn Does to Your Brain video for the psychological impact of these addictions. I also shared more insights on the science that supports NOFAP in my NOFAP on Science video. You should consider your masturbation and porn habits because they could potentially derail you on your path to mastery in your craft. The life you have always wanted is attainable, but addiction would be the enemy. You should watch my Porn is Destroying Your Life video for more on this. What is NOFAP? Just to make sure that we're on the same track, I know I've been using some terms that some aren't really familiar with. I'll shortly explain what NOFAP is. It is a movement that started on a Reddit forum discussion in 2011 about trying to quit masturbation. The movement commenced following the release of a study that showed a 145.7% increase in testosterone levels in men when compared to the former baseline amount, just after 7 days of not masturbating. The Reddit universe went crazy over this claim, so NOFAP became a thing and the discussion moved from Reddit to a wider stage on the internet. While many are advocates of the movement's ideas, several people are skeptical about its effectiveness. NOFAP rules. NOFAP has a website and according to it, there aren't any really rigid rules. However, the community encourages participants to abstain from masturbation, porn use, and possibly partner sex for a particular time. So NOFAP cautions about porn, masturbation, orgasm, also known as PMO. Some proponents of NOFAP also try to avoid edging, which is the practice of bringing yourself to just the cusp of orgasm and then stopping. This is seen by some in the movement as masturbating without achieving orgasm. Many proponents also regard porn as anything that would compel them to masturbate. Essentially, it does not have to involve nudity, but just be sexually suggestive enough to cause significant arousal. Therefore, NOFAP likes to keep its rules from being insanely rigid. Everyone has various goals and motivations that this community wants to encourage. The major goal, as NOFAP sees it, is to reboot the brain. They hope to assist those involved to rest. They hope to assist those involved to reset their neural pathway, so sex compulsions do not have such an appeal. This reboot is supposed to be for 90 days, although NOFAP leaves this open to the discretion and interpretations of participants. The best NOFAP strategy. There is no one-size-fits-all method to abstaining from PMO, but there must be a strategy in place. If you are serious about NOFAP, you must embark on a concrete plan that will see you triumph, or else you will relapse easily, much to your disappointment. Because there are no strict guidelines as to quitting an addiction, the NOFAP strategy I'm about to unravel is subjective, as it worked effectively for me. So I'll be sharing my experience, the challenges with each step on the way, and ultimately how I became PMO-free. So, are you ready to be PMO-free and have developed a strong resolve? This is where the journey started for me. I came to the realization that porn and masturbation were holding me back from being the best version of myself, so I chose to stop them and set my gaze on the prize. The strategy I'm about to share is also for those who have repeatedly tried out several organized and formal plans to quit, but ended up stuck for some reason. Number 1, change a habit at a time. According to a study, if you focus on establishing a habit for 30 days, your likelihood of continuing that habit a year later is 80%. However, if you add a second habit to those 30 days, your one-year success rate drops significantly to 35%. So adding one more thing means that you are probably going to fail at both. What is required of you is to choose one habit and be patient. Remember, you are in the game for the long haul. Be it an investment, a degree, a career in tech, coming from a non-STEM background, queue for COVID vaccination, and so on. Things that are worthwhile all require patience. And if you will leave that habit you've been struggling with, you can't afford to be impatient with yourself. So, one habit at a time, it helps you keep a focused mindset on your goal. Wherever you go, whatever you do, you will often have the consciousness that NOFAP is the end goal. If you want to achieve something, keep your goal short. Yes, when the desired goal is elaborate or complex, it could be hard to reach. But when it is simple and clear, you will hardly be distracted. There is also a good chance that you will sight threats from afar, and that will help you neutralize them even before they arrive. For example, you avoid things that easily crumble your resolve as regards to pornography and masturbation. It could be a TV show or a certain place you pass. By avoiding these triggers, you place yourself in a position not to be vulnerable. The harder it is to be vulnerable, the stronger your grip over unwanted habits. Just make sure it is one habit at a time, as earlier said. You've got to be strategic in applying your NOFAP strategy. Furthermore, you can do other things during the 30 days of staying away from the habit, but just keep the major thing the major thing. In my experience, the major thing was NOFAP, but I added a daily cold showers and early sleep. Add these: daily medication, some sort of exercise, keeping my room tidy and clean, practicing a hobby I enjoy, staying hydrated, eating fruit and vegetables every day. You should check out my No Nut Plus Cold Showers 30 Days video for more on these. Those are bonuses though. Getting a cold shower, for example, was not really the main thing for me, and I actually didn't care if I didn't get those things during the day. Then, the only thing that determined success or failure for me was NOFAP. Also, note that it is not easy to maintain a long-term schedule. It requires dedication and hard work. With time, it will become a natural part of your life and routine, but early on, you may have to force yourself to do the activities, and that is fine. Number 2, keep a sticker chart. This is a visual representation of your journey and it can be motivating. Here is what I mean. Use a calendar, if possible, print and post on your fridge, anything that works for you. Then give yourself a star for every day you follow your good habit. This lets you see your progress and even gives you pure satisfaction. If you follow through, without a doubt, your brain will approach what you're doing as a worthwhile venture. So a sense of seriousness is duly engendered. Number 3, be occupied. In your NOFAP journey, being occupied is how you position yourself not to be vulnerable. And truth be told, you will be tempted. You will have moments when you just want to quit and run back to masturbation and porn. What will you do when you find yourself alone, depressed, bored, and a computer is staring you in the face? Without a plan, you are done for. I plan to do 20 to 30 prostrations, then I'll send a text of what I just did to my accountability partner, my friend. And if I'm within reach, I'll take a cold shower as well. A physical prostration is to go from standing, kneeling, and touching the forehead to the ground. All the while, I'm reciting quotes in my head. The details of the quotes do not matter. What does is that my plan required a physical action that keeps me occupied and away from my computer, or whatever the trigger is. Number 4, having an accountability partner. One of the strongest forces there is for people today is social measure, but you can use it to your benefit. When I'm tempted, I'll send a text to my friend who happens to be my accountability partner, saying something like, "I think I might screw up, please let's see later today." Ensure that the accountability partner is someone you can trust, who is reliable, and whose opinion you value. Number 5, daily reinforcements. I reinforced my NOFAP ideas and growth steps regularly. I also joined a NOFAP group where I shared my story and progress. It was like a daily update, and I discovered that it helped a lot of people who were struggling too. Daily reinforcement can have an impact on the community as much as it does on you. I also get thrilled regarding people's success stories every day. It's so refreshing to see people genuinely happy just from making difficult life decisions. Number 6, discard temptations. Like I said earlier, temptations will come and you must expect them. But do not give in to that strong compulsion. Please understand that the more temptation you allow festering around you, the more likely you will relapse. So work on your willpower and exercise it. If you are faced with enough temptation, it will overpower your willpower and you'll cave in. Get rid of your porn stash, put a filter on your computer, avoid situations where you typically watch porn, masturbate, and orgasm. Leaving that inviting material around doesn't make you stronger, it just makes it easier to undo all the efforts you've put in to stop this habit. Number 7, keep your eyes on the prize, one step at a time. Don't think of how you will go through this month without watching porn and masturbating. Rather, set your mind on how you will go through that day without indulging in the habit. Having a 30 to 60 to 90 day plan with less focus on your immediate challenges will sound too big and daunting. Going PMO free today gives you the confidence to achieve the same thing tomorrow and on and on. Nothing can force you to relapse at this moment. This is where you have the choice and power. Tomorrow is not within your control, much less 90 days from now. But today is all you've got. So, there you have it. 7 practical things that explain my NOFAP journey. It's the best strategy that worked for me, and I'll keep recommending it. You could falter along the way, but do not beat yourself up. As long as you're ready to take the NOFAP challenge again and leave behind other destructive habits, it will work for you. Thanks for watching.